Right. So yeah, Baron, I said this thing sim about all the fucking switches and everything you have than it is interacting with other people. So like starting up this helicopter, it's a pretty quick process. All the circuit breakers. Turn my batteries on. Converter to manual. Fire extinguisher. GPU to start. Tanks on with fuel shut off valves on. Start of my APU. I'm gonna see a temperature rise here past 600 degrees Celsius. So my APU is good to go. I can start churning on my two turbine engines that are there on the top of the helicopter. Alright, so I'm going to start the left one first. Alright, so I'm going to disengage the rotor brake here. I've got left engine selected in start position. Hold that button down for 2 seconds. I'm going to see the starter on. Disengage the stop engine lever. And then I'm going to see rotor RPM and engine RPM start to rise from my left engine. And you can see the rotors are starting to spin out there. Once this little starter light turns off and my engine RPM is up above 60, I can start to turn my right engine on. I'm on battery power right now. You're not supposed to turn on all your avionics and stuff, but I'll go ahead and do that too while it's spooling, while the right engine's spooling up. Alright, let's see, my engine RPM is up high enough. My light should be extinguished. Flip this back over to the right side. I'm going to start my right engine. See the light pop back on. Disengage the right engine, the stop engine. And I'm going to see the right engine start to spool up. While it's doing that, I'm going to turn my avionics on. Left attitude indicator, gyro, the audible warnings, and my pitch limiter. And over on the right side, I've got Doppler system and communications, and my right attitude indicator. Then I'm also going to turn on my radar altimeter to give it time to do its bit test. All right, so my right engine is almost entirely powered on. So now that it's powered on, I no longer need my APU. I can go ahead and shut that off. And before I turn on my generators, because the generators won't work unless I have RPM, I'm going to turn my throttle up. The throttle is the twist here on the collective. I'm going to go ahead and twist that all the way up to max. I'm going to see my engine start to rise. The governors are going to kick on and the needle's going to come back down. Alright, governors kicked on from my my engine RPM. Good. My radar altimeter light should be turning on here shortly. I'm not going to wait for it though. I'm going to switch over to the, I'm going to turn on my electrical systems now. I'm going to turn the generators on and the rectifiers on, and then switch my inverters to auto. Alright. Radar altimeter light turned on. I just need to go reset it so I can do stuff. Now that light's going to pop back on when I drop below 10 meters. In the right side, I'm going to turn my countermeasures panel on and make it so that it launches two sets of three flares. And I'm ready to go. Oh, I have to cage my attitude indicators so they're level. And turn on my autopilot from the flight engineer position.